Alrighty, hey guys, this is Peter from Techno Cocktail, and today I'm going to be playing a bit of Portal 2 with the perpetual motion testing thing. Here we go. Here's
Cave Johnson here. Every time I look at our test chamber production line, I am reminded of my father. Now, he wasn't a scientist, just a simple farmer, a professor of farming at the local farm college. Never farmed a day in his life, but his theories on farming are the backbone of this company. Do it from scratch. Spare no expense. And never cut corners. Well, that's a corner-cutting machine. We obviously cut them there. Point is, we've always done things the way my father did. And his father before him, and his father before him, and his father before him. And we are almost bankrupt. So, time for a cheaper approach. Allow me to introduce the multiverse. Infinite Earths with an infinite number of apertures.
Ooh, look at
and
that
as of now, they are going to take over all test chamber construction. And more importantly, all paying for test chamber construction. Why are they agreeing to do that? They're not. We're tricking them. Here's how it works. 1. Design a test. 2. Slip the mole monsters or what have you the blueprint when they're not looking. 3. Once they build it, steal it back. Look at that sad little octopus. That's where you come in. We need blueprints. We are about to run the greatest con game in the history of the multiverse, and you are the bottleneck. Yes, you. Get back to work.
Okay, so here we go. Let's get this started. So, create a test chamber. Let's do this. So, we've got the menu. Oh, I like the things on the right here. The buttons and stuff. View my workshop. No, let's create a test chamber. Here we go. Standard little shell thing. Today is the 8th of May, so it did come out today. There we go. I'm assuming. Okay, so it's right click to just drag it around, middle mouse button to look around like this. Okay, here's the exit door. Here's the entrance. Ooh, so it's click and drag to do that. Okay. So let's just do this quickly. So let's move the door entrance up here. Select this face, like that, put that like that, then, ooh, okay, like so, let's move this. Let's try take the ceiling. Okay, so basically here on the left you've got this little bar which has the buttons and all the... Ooh, look, even the messed up droid. The light bridge, the... I've forgotten his name now. The faith plate, there we go. The redirection cube, some light, so that's nice. It's a nice touch. There we go. Back to this, sorry. So yeah, let's fill this with water. There we go. And then we'll have, let's put a... One of these, I've forgotten the name, I think it's called a tractor. We're gonna have to make the ceiling a bit higher. It's just standard basic controls to edit rooms with, like any other one. Okay, so this will be pushing out that way, and then we'll have, let's put a button over here, so let's extend out this a bit, like so, there we go, and we'll put a cube button over there, we'll make a cube spawner here, that's nice, it automatically makes a cube spawner. And then let's make that. And then it comes up to here. Let's move that one across so it's under the cube spawner. And like so. And we'll have two of those so we can walk across. Okay, then let's right click. That gives you all the options. So, button type, cube, connect to the exit door. Oh, we made like a little hearty thing, yay! Sorry, I'm getting distracted quite easily. This is amazing, I must say. Go, and then over here we can just have this out like so, and then we'll have a timed button which will face that way, which will be right click, connect to this, change polarity, make it 5 seconds, and let's give it a shot. So file, and switch to game view, I guess. Yeah, wow, that's nice. What? Did I exit the editor? Do I have to save, maybe? Save? Okay. First shot. No need, really. Save. Okay, saving your test chamber. Switch to game view. Maybe you have to go through here? Oh, okay, it says in the bottom corner. File. Rebuild.
Click a chamber surface tile to select it.
Well, that's helpful. There we go.
Aperture.
It was a joke. Haha. Venture. Ooh. There we go. Oh wow. Well, there's my first problem. Okay, exit to editor. So we're gonna need to have some stairs here. Ooh, that's too long. There we go. Have one of these. What? What's the problem? Invalid position. No. What? There we go. And then we'll have you know what? Let's undo that. I'm just pressing Ctrl Z, by the way. Delete. And we'll have bounce gel there, which will only appear and this button over here gets pressed. Connect to bounce gel. Gel flow, let's put that at a drip. Perfect. So file, rebuild.
Rebuilding your test chamber.
Oh, that's nice. Look, it tells you how far it is. Ooh, that was a bit laggy. There we go. Loading your level, I'm guessing. There we go. Ooh, shiny. Use the lights turn on. Oh, right. I need to actually hook these things up. Let's put another button here. This one. Connect to. And that one. Is that possible? Did that work? Okay, that didn't work. Okay, it did work. Okay, never mind. Let's make this a bit longer, though. Make this 20 seconds. There we go. Say rebuild. Give it a minute. So yeah, I encourage you guys to go check this out if you guys own Portal 2. This isn't in Portal 1, it's Portal 2. It does seem quite nice and friendly. I did have the original one that was used to make maps, but ugh, that was a pain in the backside to get working nicely, so. Okay, this button makes it drop it down. Right, I'm not awake today. There we go, and then we'll put an aerial faceplate. Ooh, wow. Let's put an aerial faceplate over here. Again, aerial faceplate. Like so. There we go. Hopefully. There. Here we are. So, Crap. Let's try that again. No! Why am I failing so badly? Oh, come on. Oh, really now? No! Okay. Drop that on the aerial face plate. No! Goo down. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little like short review. I'll probably be doing a few more episodes once I've made a few levels in this. But see you guys in a later episode. Cheers.